Hello and welcome to the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast. And this weekend I bring to you the 2004 British gangster movie Layer Cake. Now, if the truth be known, I do not have a fondness for the ubiquitous British East End of London Cockney crime pool flick. In fact, I try to avoid them like the plague. I only went to see this one in the cinema because there was nothing else on, but I can tell you that I'm very glad that I did, and it has subsequently made its way into my personal DVD collection. It is also the film that introduced me to Daniel Craig, Sienna Miller and Ben Whishaw. The name of the protagonist of Layer Cake is never revealed to the viewer, not even as part of the credits. He is simply a small-time cocaine dealer who likes to keep his team small, stay away from guns and, of course, the end user, as a means to an end, and that end is getting the hell out of the business. He believes that he has safely stashed away or invested enough of his ill-gotten gains to retire at some point in the not-too-distant future. But what he doesn't realize is that criminal enterprises are far easier to get into than to get out of. The days of maintaining some sort of honor amongst thieves seem to have been lost to the past. Our protagonist's latest series of ventures all seem to be escalating out of control, with dead bodies turning up everywhere. His name and that of his team has been bandied about by street-level dealers and thugs on the rampage in Amsterdam, and as a result, an assassin has been dispatched in their direction by a group of organized criminals who made their money in the former Yugoslavia and who are, in fact, wanted by the UN for war crimes against humanity. He attempts to clear up this horrendous misunderstanding without actually realizing that he has been set up for a fall. There are so many great lines in this film that I found it hard to choose one for the subtitle of this edition, and they are not restricted to the main characters, and that has to be the key compliment that I can give to this film. Round this off with the production values being so slick as to be reminiscent of, dare I say, Hollywood, it is plain to see that this project was a labour of love for both the director of the film and the author of the book upon which it is based. Now, I've already stated that I'm not a fan of this genre, but it does seem to have the most international success, which is something that the UK film industry is short of, to say the least. And it is, of course, how Guy Ritchie, who is arguably the most well-known contemporary British director, made his name. His style of direction has even been copied by Hollywood with Lucky Number 11, which is a blatant rip-off of Ritchie's Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels movies. But I believe that this phenomenon started in the 1980s with The Craze, chronicling the demise of the infamous Cray twin brothers, who terrorised the East End of London during, I believe, the 1950s and 60s. And anyone who is really into this kind of thing will have been aware of the stream of autobiographies from former Cockney gangsters straight out of prison, or maybe still in prison, that flooded onto the bookshelves during the 1990s and the noughties. I'm your host, Shay Trinity. And as always, this has been an Eskimo Finn production. Do follow me on Twitter. I am at Eskimo Finn.